When I was a child, I wanted to be a cook. I wanted to make dishes that people would enjoy. I wanted to have a restaurant. And I must have taken a wrong turn somewhere because I ended up being a mathematician instead. Truth is, I once had a glimpse at the fascinating beauty of mathematics. And I remained forever trapped in it since then. Just like a fly that looks at a bright light and is trapped then. You know, what's nice with mathematics is that it's at the center of everything you know, even if you don't realize it. When you take a train, when you look at your cell phone, just like you would, when you turn your oven on, in all these things, you are using mathematical tools without knowing it. In nature as well, when you see the sunrise, when you look at northern lights, when you see a waterfall, in all these things, there is a common point, a common language, and this language is called mathematics. And the people who understand this language are called mathematicians. So, mathematics is something very beautiful, but I'm sure you will agree with me if I tell you that mathematics is also extremely complex, right? Yeah. So, when a few years ago we started seeing jobs being replaced by machines, AI, doing amazing things, I thought, there is one thing, I mean, there's one job that will never get replaced. It's this ability to design mathematics. And today, I'm going to show you how wrong I was. So this is going to be a story, the beautiful story of AI and mathematics. And as any story, it has its heroes. And we'll start with those two guys. So we're back in 2018. They were engineering students, barely older than you. And they did something amazing. They trained an AI that could translate from one language to another without any Rosetta Stone. So picture this. You have a first pile of books in French, so for instance, your favorite Rougon-Macquart collection that you all have, I'm sure. Then a pile of books in English, I don't know, Shakespeare's play, whatever you like. Then you have an AI that doesn't know anything about French or English, then you put everything in a room for a few hours, and at the end of the day, the AI is able to translate from French to English. And, I mean, think about it. There are no books in common. There is no common dictionary. I mean, how come this is possible? I didn't even thought this could be. Whoa. So, I don't know for you, but this sounded like black magic to me. And I thought, okay, if an AI is able to do such black magic, maybe, I mean, just maybe, one day, it could solve mathematics. So some other people started thinking the same, and they thought, what if you can see math as a translation problem? You have a first language, the problem, and another language, the solutions. If you're able to translate from the first one to the second one, then you just solve some mathematics. So those two people tried, and they brought me with them, and what we did was the following. Take a complicated problem, like this. Is the linear system of the following dynamical system controllable? So, okay, I'm aware I just sounded like speaking ancient Greek to a French-speaking audience. But you don't need to understand what I just said. The only thing you need to understand are the following. One, there are a bunch of equations. Right. Two, this is a master-level problem. So you will probably study this in first or second year in university, in master's, so here it will be in deux ans, as we say in French. And three, the answer can only be yes or no. And in this setting, there is a chance level at 50, meaning that if you guess at random, you have 50% chance of having the right answer. So we trained an AI to try to answer this question, and we did it as follows. We just give it a lot of examples. So like you see, your first example, the answer is false. Second example is false. Third example, it's true. So if you have no clue and you don't know why it's true or false, don't worry, the AI doesn't either, and me neither. you give a lot of examples and you hope that at the end of the day, the AI can catch the mathematics behind and answer the question if you ask it again. And you know, if you guess at random, you get 50% of right answers. So we hope for like 60% of right answers, maybe 70, 80. But what happened instead was this. We had 97% of right answers, meaning that the AI was nearly perfect on this problem. And this is huge. So why do I say it's huge? Well, because when I tried the exact same question on students of this university, I only got 75%. And I mean, 75% is not bad. I mean, it's actually pretty good. The only thing is the AI is better. So let's summarize. Chimpanzees will get about 50%. Master students from Ecole Desponts will be between 70 and 80, depending on the years. I mean, this year is a good year. And AI will be at 97%. So this looked amazing to us. But there's just one thing. The AI is not really proving anything. It's guessing something. And I'm sure you all know mathematics is about proving things, not guessing stuff. I'm sure you know because you've all had this annoying math teacher telling you giving the final result is not enough. You need to explain me how you get it if you want to have the points. And for some of you, I know you know this because I am your annoying math teacher. So the real question is, can an AI write a proof? Or can it even prove a theorem? So this might look like a science fiction dream, but this sci-fi dream is not very far from reality, actually. And as surprising as it may seem, computers have been used in mathematical proofs for years. I think the easiest example is the following. So it dates from 1769. Don't worry, they didn't have a computer at the time. But Euler at the time, in addition of being a man dressed in pyjamas, was one of the most brilliant mathematicians of his time. And he made a conjecture, something he thinks is true. He said, if you have some integers, k integers, such that when you put them to the power n, and then you sum them, and it's equal to another integer to the power n, then in this case, you need k to be larger than n. In other words, you need at least n integers. And this remained an open problem for 200 years. So no mathematician on Earth has been able to solve this problem for 200 years. So this until Lander and Parkin arrived in 1966, and they solved this problem in the most silly way you can ever imagine. They just tried all the possible numbers with a computer. And they found this. So Euler said that if you have to do this with the power 5, you need at least 5 integers on the left-hand side, and you see here you can count there's only 4. So Euler was wrong. And this was a new mathematical proof. Don't need to read this, I mean, this is the paper. So, of course, it's a new mathematical proof, but it's mostly the proof that even if you're called Euler, you can, again, make mistakes. The only problem is that then humanity takes 200 years to spot your mistakes. So a more serious example is the example of the Keller conjecture. So I'm not even going to try to explain you what the Keller conjecture is, don't worry. The only thing you need to know is that it's a proof where there are a lot of simple cases. It's easy to check one case, but there are many, many, many of them. Far, far too much for a human. And so this was solved with a computer. And at the end of the day, the proof is so big that you're not even asking how many pages is the proof. You're asking how many gigabytes is the proof. And the answer is 200, about 10 times Wikipedia. So you know, I thought, OK, I'm going to show you the proof. This is going to be a fun night. But I couldn't convince the organizers, so. So in this example, in the previous one, the only problem is that the computer is really needed. But it's only computing. The humans are still doing the thinking. And this is what we're interested with, right? The thinking. So can an AI do the thinking? And if you're in 2023 and you want to answer this question, what do you do? I mean, you ask your favorite homework buddy, ChatGPT, right? And you start with a simple problem like this one, and you say, OK, can I store 6 red balls and 3 blue balls in a tube that contains 7 balls? And the answer you get is yes. So then you can stop reading after this, because the right answer is no. And it's not amazing. But it's not really surprising, because if you take a look at what's behind ChatGPT, it's just an AI, a transformer, that is a magical box that is trained to take a sentence in input and try to predict what is the next most likely word. So if you trained it properly, in this case, it will probably say France with a few other responses that are bad. And this is made to sound human, not to solve math problems. But then two other people thought, okay, maybe we can do the same, but instead of giving sentences, we can give it math proofs. And we hope that it will output a proof step. And by doing this, they were able to have an AI that can prove high school exercise, just like this one. So of course, it's not super hard, but the AI will prove it much in a better way than you would or I would. And then we thought, with the Evariste team at Meta, can we do better than that? Can we go even further, like do better math? And we thought, okay, there is this AI that was released in 2017 called AlphaZero. It plays chess against itself, and after a few days, it's better than any human. Can we do the same with math? Can we see math as a game? You know, and okay, a complicated game, maybe a boring one, but at least each time you apply a theorem, you're just making a move, and if you make enough move at the end of the day and you have nothing left to prove, then you won. Right? This kind of game. I assure you, this is a game. So when you do this, you need to be very, very careful, because the AI can be clever in ways you don't expect. For instance, after a few months trying this, we quickly had a success rate of 100%. And whenever you see a success rate of 100%, this needs to be a red light, because there's a huge difference between 99 and 100. Turns out the AI was proving anything by using the well-known fact that 2 is equal to 3. Now, to explain you how the AI was proving that 2 is equal to 3, I need to tell you about something else, something that some of you know, the exponential function. So the exponential function is the function that grows very quickly to infinity whenever you're looking at big numbers. And then when you're looking at big negative numbers, it goes very quickly to zero. So I'm sure you all know this. The only thing you might not realize is how quick this is. So I have a question for you. Imagine you have a blackboard and a teacher is drawing an exponential function. One corresponds to 1 millimeter. My question is, where is exponential 56? So I'm going to give you a few seconds to think about it, and then I'm going to ask you. So go ahead, think about it. Don't use your cell phone. All right? OK. Who thinks, so just to give you a hint, this will be exponential 0, this will be exponential 1, this will be exponential 5. Exponential 56, OK. Who votes for option A on the top of the board? OK, that's impressive. Who votes for option B on the roof? I know I had WizKids here. Who votes for option C? OK, that turns out to be apparently still option A. On the moon. Wow, OK. Who votes for option D/B in another galaxy? All right, so I knew I had WizKids here, because the right answer is indeed in the next galaxy. So this goes very, very, very quickly to infinity, or very, very quickly to zero. And so what the AI did was saying, OK, 2 equal 3 is equivalent to say that exponential 2 is equal to exponential 3, and we go on and on and on. And this is perfectly correct, right? The only problem is that this last quantity here, exponential exponential 2, is huge. So if you add a minus, it's a huge negative number. And if you take the exponential of that, this thing is so close to zero that if you make the mistake of giving to your AI a numerical calculator, the calculator will only see 0 equals 0 and say it's good. And so the AI tricked you. So OK, so after fixing this and literally a thousand other things in time lapse of 2 years, we ended up having an AI that could prove even better math and even some exercise from the most prestigious student competition in the world, the International Mathematical Olympiads. Some of you might have been there. Yeah? OK. For instance, it was able to show this thing. So this is an exercise for you. Can you show that 7 never divides 2 to the power n plus 1 for any n? Yeah, I heard it. It's complicated. So of course, for n equals 0, that's relatively easy. For n equals 5, I guess you can manage it. Now, what happens for n equals 42? Yeah, I don't know. What happens for n equals 345? Or even n is equal to 2 to the power 42? You know, the fact that an AI is able to solve this kind of problem, let me tell you, this makes mathematicians like me shiver. I remember that when I was a kid, I was fascinated by the Google search. And this sounds completely ridiculous today, right? But think about it. 6 years ago, having an AI that could output a full sentence in French, I mean, this sounded fascinating. And today, this sounds so boring. And now, today, having an AI that can solve a math exercise seems fascinating. So my question for you is, how do you think it's going to be like tomorrow? And, you know, I looked a lot at the AI that is able to play chess against itself and becomes better than any human. And I realized something recently. It's not the AI that is perfect. It's the humans that are very bad at playing this game. So maybe one day we'll realize that since Pythagoras and Euclid, after all, maybe we've just been very bad at math as well. Thank you for your attention.